Ah, it is recording. Hi guys, this is Tash, the Starcross Stitcher. I hope you're all doing well. I'm really good, thanks for asking. I've got some notes, I've got a finish, I've got some whips, I've got some stash, I've got some plans. I've got a lot of things, and I'm going to try and get it done quickly, so let's move on. I hope you're all good. It's been a long time since my last video, and that's just because I'm lazy. I was going to make one this weekend because we just had a long weekend for, I was about to say Invasion Day, for Australia Day. There's a bit of controversy about Australia Day in Australia. I won't get into it. But we had a long weekend and it was really good. And I did a lot of stitching and I had a finish. And I didn't make a video because I was lazy. And I'm going away next weekend and the weekend after. So I don't know when my next video will be, so I thought I'd better get it done. And I got home from work today. All afternoon, I was thinking I'm gonna make my video. I was making notes, I was planning it. And then I got home and I just went in the shower and put my pajamas on before I realized that, oh yeah, I'm supposed to be making a video. Oops. So it's pajama tube tonight. I'm wearing my pajamas. Okay, I am going to address a bunch of comments that people left me in the last like five videos that I just have not replied to because I'm terrible. This fabric, remember this fabric, the Phantom from Picture This Plus sale, and it's got these white bits on it that I hate. A lot of you left suggestions, and you're all geniuses, thank you. I'm going to grab some navy blue or purple dye and just fix these great big huge spots of white. That's what I'm going to do. Thank you very much for the suggestions. I should have thought of that, and now that I've thought of it, it's going to be quite small. They are really big spots. I'm worried that, it won't be perfect and it won't look good. When I was thinking about it, I was thinking, oh, no worries, just little spots, but they're huge spots. So I will try it. The worst thing that happens is the fabric has to be cut into smaller pieces to be used, really. And I have to get something else for, what's it for? The evening tea party or something, the Mirabilia one. It's really pretty, that one. The one that I've put a picture of right here. The garden party, maybe. Okay, what's next? Right, the Red Mermaid kit that I showed you in the last video. The person who I saw stitch that was handmade. Thank you for everyone who reminded me that it was handmade. You should go and watch Handmaid's videos. She's amazing. She's new to me. She's not new. I think she's got three or four videos up now. I went back and watched all of her old videos. She's amazing. I love everything she does. I want to be her when I grow up. I love her. She's way younger than me. I love her. I want to be her. So I saw her picture of her finish of Red Mermaid on, not Etsy, on Instagram, and that's what made me buy the chart, the kit. So thank you to everyone who reminded me that it was handmade. Handmaide. Another floss tuber that I've just discovered is Every Stitch a Pleasure. Her name's Christine. I love everything she does too. I want to be her when I grow up. And I want to be Cozy Egg. And I want to be Lisa stitching and stuff. I love everybody. Oh, I just feel not good enough when I watch those people. I want to stitch everything they're doing. Everything. Okay, a few videos ago I was complaining about international postage. My complaint hasn't changed. I'm still complaining. I think I discovered that one of the reasons why the cost might be high is because of the eBay International Shipping Program. So apparently sellers will just post their stuff to the eBay distribution center and then eBay will forward it overseas. And they have set prices for their postage. So that's why they're so expensive. A few of you offered to let me send mail to you and you'll forward it to me. Thank you all. You're so kind to offer that. Really, it's so kind. I can't believe you would offer that. I do actually have kind of a solution that I can use, which is send it to my dad's work in America, and he goes over there about three times a year. Actually, he's already gone twice this year, so he goes over there quite frequently, and he can pick it up and bring it home for me. The problem is, someone who works there has to go and pick up the parcels or collect the parcels or sign for the parcels and then they have to keep them somewhere. So I can't use it too often, but that's probably a good thing because it makes me restrain my buying. So thank you everyone who offered. I do have a solution for parcels in America. Thank you. What's next? okay, that's all the administration. Good. I've had two finishes. The first finish I can't show you. It was my secret whip for the Year of Whips. We had to do a secret whip that represented soulful stitching. The Year of Whips, if you didn't know, is put on by Melanie Watkins in the Soulful Stitching Group. I finished my secret whip. I started it on the 18th when Year of Whips started, and it took me 2 days. It wasn't very big. And I really like it, and I can see it over there, but I can't show you because it's secret. I will show you at the end of the year. Year of Whips ends on December 18th, so you can just wait until then. But this finish I can show you. Ta-da! Oh, she's so pretty. Oh, you can see all the beads. I love her. This is Shroomhilda by Terence Nolan of Dimples Designs. And she is wonderful, isn't she? Look at her. Look at her. She's so sparkly. She's got blending filament all in her armor here, and in her belly and in her head, her cap. You know, and you can see the beads here and here. Oh yeah, and the shield is very sparkly. These are water lilies in the border, these two. The border is all backstitched with, it called for Krynek 001, but I couldn't find it. Oh, I went to my L&S, they didn't have it. I had someone order from 123 Stitch, but the order's been delayed. Every time I go there, it says, it'll ship in 2 days, but just waiting for the Krynek. And then I go back 2 days later to check and it says, oh, it'll ship in 2 more days, but just waiting for the Krynek. So I pilfered from another thing I have kitted up in my stash, and I found 001HL, which is the high luster version of the silver, and I think it looks fine. So this was a pain in the bum, this border. It was so annoying. Like, not only is it the water lilies and I wanted to do individual stitches, then I had to backstitch the entire border. And make no mistake, there's a double border and all of this. I had to backstitch it all with the Krynek. Not fun. As I was stitching this, I thought to myself many times, I'm just going to leave the border off, it's fine. It's too much work, I'm not going to do it. But I'm really glad I did it because she is gorgeous. She's so beautiful, I love her. Yeah, love her. Love her. God, she was a lot of work though. This was 70 hours of work, which is more than that Mirabilia full coverage mermaid. Yeah, she was a lot of work. I think I didn't enjoy stitching her for about the last half. I think I just got burnt out because I was just pushing to finish because I want to pass the chart on. Drew, do you still want the chart? Do you want to swap? We were doing a swap. I can't remember the details. Drew and I were going to swap charts. I'll message you on Instagram. Yes, Instagram. Okay. So there's my finish. That's two finishes this year. This was also a Year of Whips piece. Yay me! I need to finish more than two a month because I have 25 pieces on my Year of Whips and I have only 11 months to finish them. 18th of December it ends, so yeah, that's more than two a month I need to finish. I only have to finish half of that number, but I'd like to finish them all. So yeah, that one's done. Check off the list. You know, I feel like my relationship with a piece is kind of over when I'm finished it. I mean, I know I'll probably frame her and put her up on the wall and she's beautiful and I don't stop liking her, but you know, you see the piece online and you put it in your shopping cart and then you start kitting it up, choosing the fabric, and then you get it and you start working on it. Then by the time it's finished, I kind of feel like that's the end of my relationship with the piece. That's all I'm saying. Starts when you first start kitting it up and then it's over at this point. And I don't feel the need to keep them around so much. I'm going to put her somewhere. I want to hang a fishing line up here, a la Abby Bella Stitch, and hang some more finishes up there. I have one over here, which I haven't showed you yet, but I will. So she might go away and never to be seen again. Okay, I've been working on other things. I've been working on And a Forest Grew. And as you can see, I've made it to the middle point. So here is the big tree in the middle of the garden. So I don't know what you saw last time. I also did the bunnies. I don't know if you saw that big tree. I don't know what you saw, but that's what I've done. This is a stitch along I'm doing with my mum. I do two motifs a week. My mum hasn't worked on it in about 6 months, so I'm way ahead of her. Big news on this week, I have decided on the quote I want to put in the middle. Where's that piece of paper? It's here. So if you don't know, the original looks like this. This is my working copy. And the quote in the middle is something very Jesus-y. And out of the ground, the Lord God made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to sight and good food. The tree of life also in the midst of the garden and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. So I'm going to change that because I'm not really into that. And I found one that I like. This says, Flowers, plants and fishes, beasts, birds, flies, beads, hills, dales, plains, pastures, skies, seas, rivers, trees. There's nothing near at hand or furthest sought, but with my needle may be shaped and wrought. I like that. It's kind of about nature, and a lot of the things that are listed are stitched here, but it kind of puts the focus back on the stitching, back on the fact that this is a piece of handwork, and it makes it a little more samplery. This quote came from a sampler. I heard this on Stitch M's channel. She got a chart from The Good Housewife, and it was called With My Needle. And this was the verse on it. It was so beautiful. I love it. So I don't know if... I need to credit Anne from The Good Housewife as the author of the quote, or if she got that quote from somewhere else. And I don't know how to find that out, as I don't have the chart from The Good Housewife because it's out of print. But surely I'm allowed to use a quote without buying the chart, especially if it's out of print. I do have a search on eBay now for this chart, for that chart, but I haven't had a single hit since I put the search on. So anyway, I think that quote will be lovely here. I will figure out how to chart it so it fits in the space. I think it will fit in the space because it's not too long. It's about the same length as the original. So yeah, I'm so happy about that. But I won't get to the quote until I'll go all the way across the bottom and then go up to the top and come back. So, yay! I'm very happy about that. Gosh, I don't have enough space to put things. I've also been working on Tranquility Sampler. So, I have shown you this. Don't know if I showed it in my last video, but I've definitely shown it in previous videos. If you've been around for a long time, you've seen it. This is called the Tranquility Sampler by Stikkedien von der Weyenberg. I don't know if I said that right. I started it when it was a mystery sampler back in 2007. So what I've decided to do is, because every weekend I'm working on two motifs on Ender Forest Grew, I'm also going to each weekend work on one motif on here. So I think since last you saw this, I finished off this dark brown one. I've done this peacock one and this pink one. Yep. Yeah, I really like this. It's stitched 1/1 on 32 count opalescent Lagana from Silkweaver called Cashmere Glitz. And I know you can see how sparkly that is. and that's my angry cat needle minder, which I got the wood piece from Pork Chop Show, made my own. What else to say? It's all stitched in Gentle Arts and Weeks, just random threads, in just colours I liked. So yeah, that's that one. And then after I finished Shroomhilda, there's no room to put everything. After I finished Shroomhilda, I decided to start working on Fire and Ice by Custom Crafts. This is my oldest whip. I think I started this in 2004 or 5 or 3, something like that. And you also haven't seen this for a really long time. I worked on this for one day in Mania last year. Let me put that behind. There we go. So you can see where I'm working, just on the top of the horse. That's the top third. This is a 6-page chart, so there's page 1 is here, page 2, page 3, page 4, page 5, page 6. Yep. So as my oldest whip, this is my most important large project to finish this year. And I'm actually enjoying working on this. You know, in the past, I've not enjoyed working on this. It's not the black fabric. That's not a problem for me. I'm lucky I have a really good close-up vision. But I don't know. It's just the style of, I don't know what it is. Just the style of stitching all these, I guess, cross-country stitching. I didn't enjoy it with so many similar colours. But I think now that I've done, I've had a lot more experience with haze and so on, with really terrible confetti and stuff, this is like relaxing. I think also the fact that I was getting really sick of Schrumhilde by the end, I was actually at the time looking forward to moving on to this, so that's probably helping with why I'm enjoying this so much. So yeah, I'm working on this. I'll work on this for maybe a week or so. Until I get bored, I guess. Although I am going to be doing the Winter Olympics stitch along. And I guess I might as well tell you now what I'll be stitching for that on each day. Winter Olympics stitch along in Stitch Mania. So for each day of the Winter Olympics, there's a different theme and you stitch a piece to match the theme. So on the 9th, February 9th, the opening ceremony, stitch on a new start or your most recent start. And I'm going to have a new start because one of the other days says stitch on a Halloween piece. And I don't have any Halloween pieces, so I'm going to start one. and it's really small, so I'll definitely finish it during the event. I'll put a picture here. It's called Tomb Sweet Tomb by Fairy Wool in the Wood. She has a shop on Etsy. That is the most adorable piece ever. I love it. So cute. I might leave the snow off the people in the tree and the tombstones because it's already graveyard and Halloween-y themed. It doesn't need to also be wintery. I don't know. I'll see. I might leave the snow on just because snow is cute. Yeah, so I'll start that on that day. February 10th, Winter Olympics, stitch on any winter themed piece. This is a bit of a cheat. I don't have any wintry pieces, but I'm going to stitch on Japanese octagon box. This is a kind of a four seasons piece. As we come up, Mount Fuji comes up here. And as we come up the mountain, there's snow on the mountain in sort of the wintry part. These two panels are sort of spring. These two are kind of autumn. You can see this autumny tree. As you come up to the top of the mountain, it's winter. Oh no, this must be summer, sorry. Yeah, there's a big cherry blossom tree over here for spring. So I will work on Japanese octagon box and I will try to get up to the mountain, the top of the mountain where the snow is. February 11th, South Korea, stitch on a Korean themed piece. The Korean flag has red, blue, black, and white in it. And this has red, blue, black, and white in it. So I'll work on this. It does have white. It has two stitches of white in this horse's eye. So yeah, red, blue, black, and white. February 12th, the mascots. Stitch on any piece with an animal in it. I'll stitch on fire and ice. The 13th. Set yourself a time limit, whatever works for you, and see how much progress you can make in that time. So I'm actually going to do an experiment and see how many stitches I can do on this in 1 hour in a cross-country way. Then I might actually go for 1 hour and see how many stitches I can do parking, just to see what the difference is. Because I know that parking is slower, I just don't know how much slower. February 14th. Metal, stitch on any piece requiring metallics or beads. And I'll go back to Japanese octagon box. This is by Chatelaine, by the way, so I'm sure you can see how sparkly that these parts at the bottom are. Lots of beads and gems and metallics. So I'll stitch on that. 15th, skeleton, stitch on any Halloween themed piece. And I'll go back to Tomb Sweet Tomb, and I will probably finish that piece on this day because it's only small. Small and adorable. February 16th, biathlon. Stitch on two pieces today. And that's a Friday, so for my weekend stitching, I will work on Tranquility and a forest screw. February 17th, figure skating. Stitch on any piece that requires specialty stitches. And I'm planning on working on Wallace, the Celtic sampler. February 18th, Heaven, Earth, and Humanity. Stitch on any piece related to Heaven, Earth, and Reality. Heaven, Earth, and Humanity, which are the themes for the Olympic Games. The one I'm going to stitch on is It's called Gaze a While by The Heart's Content. The Heart's Content. Gaze a While. And this is a 40 count silk gauze kit. This is how much I've done. And I'll stitch on this obviously because she's standing on the earth and she's gazing up at the heavens. And it's so cute. There's an owl and birds and stars and moons and lots of things to gaze at. So heaven and earth. The 19th, 15 sport disciplines. Stitch on something related to the 15th, number 15. I will do 15 queen stitches on, I'm not picking it up again, 15 queen stitches on the Celtic sampler. 20, Olympic Village. Stitch on something with a house or another building. I am going to stitch on Fir Tree Mountain. Don't know if you've seen this. Don't stitch a lot of houses, so didn't have a lot of things to choose from. This set of needlework smalls, there's little houses there. I've just been working on the needlebook, so I guess I'll finish up the needlebook. Yep, that's Fir Tree Mountain by the Cat's Whiskers Design Studio. And in the past, I've actually already stitched these two, Cherry Blossom Spring and Shades of Blue Willow. And they're such a beautiful set. I really like them. Lovely to stitch on. I can't get it back in the bag. February 21st, 79 nations. Stitch something related to the numbers 7 and 9. And I think I've been very clever with this one. So, this Celtic sampler, this part of it is called Wallace. And Wallace has 7 letters. And the part next to it, on this side, it's the same size, it's the square that goes exactly next to it. That part's called Robertson, and Robertson has 9 letters. So Wallace, Robertson, 7, 9. So there we go. International competition. Stitch on a piece with an international or travel theme. Japanese Octagon box. February 23rd, host Pyeongchang. I don't even know how to say that. Pyeongchang. Stitch on something with the related to the letters P and C. So I'm going to stitch Prairie Schooler. C is for cow. So I probably won't be finished with B is for blackbird yet, but I'll just count across and start stitching on C is for cow. This is all being done in one piece. 27 count something. It's massive. I'm not even going to unfold it. It's too much hassle. February 24th, 4 events. Stitch on a piece that requires you to do something you've never done before. New design, new material, new stitch, or something like that. So I'm going to come back to this one, and we're going to work on, I can't remember which one, but one of these other motifs has a stitch that I've never done before. So I'll work on a different motif for a change. And the last day, February 25th, closing ceremony. Stitch on a piece you're close to finishing, and I will stitch on Tomb Sweet Tomb if I didn't finish it. And if I did finish it, I will go back to Fir Tree Mountain because that's pretty close to finishing, and I'll work on that one. So, oh my gosh, that's my plans coming up. I was going to show you haul before I did that, but never mind. And I've only got about 5 minutes left because I'm trying to keep my videos to about half an hour. Just because, have you guys been completely inundated by the number of videos? Especially with all these new Stitch With Me's that are coming along. Or, you know, the off-the-grid stitch-alongs. I just can't, I don't even watch those. I wish I could, I just cannot keep up. Too many new floss tubers. I'm actually going through and unsubscribing from a lot of people because I just can't watch everyone. And it's sad, I wish I could. I do. I just can't, I don't have time. I have a full-time job, I don't have time. So I'm being pretty brutal with my unsubscribes too. Just, if you don't have projects I like, bye. Unless you're like super entertaining or something, I'm probably not going to watch you. And it's sad because I do wish I could watch everyone, but it's just not possible. So haul, I'm trying to not spend much. There's a big pile of haul here, which shows you how well I'm doing at that. I'm saving up for my overseas trip. I've got other expenses coming up this year. We're looking at getting another member of our family soon. You can probably see here. We're hoping to get a puppy. Might not be that one necessarily, but we're looking for puppies. I got my fabric of the month from Tammy at Color Cascades Fabrics. Have you all heard some drama about Tammy and her stitch along and Shannon Christine Designs? Drama! I'm not getting into it. I'm not explaining it. I'm not offering an opinion. This is my December fabric of the month. Her December fabric of the month, not mine. It's 32 count linen, fat quarter. It's just called Mystery Fabric, and it's a weird one. I mean, it's really pretty. I don't know. It's actually greener. It looks quite brown on the screen. It's definitely greener. I love this like edge here. Love this dark green up here. I wish the whole fabric was like this. No, but yeah, I think it will work for something. I just don't know what. It will work. It's pretty. Oh, these fabrics smell really good too. Okay. Fabric of the month from Tammy. I still don't have the one yet from Under the Sea Fabrics for January, but I also don't have Color Cascades for January yet too. It's only the 30th, so it'll take some time. I also signed up for XGU Design Fabric of the Month in the 46 count. I'm so excited, that's on the way too. I ordered on Etsy Jenny Bean's Halloween sampler. See, I should have done this for the Halloween start. But I don't want a big one. I've got enough whips at the moment. I just want to start everything, seriously. What's hashtag start your stash? What is that? I need to hear the philosophy behind that, because it might help me to justify more starts. I have so many things that are kitted up and ready to start. I'm looking at all my kits up there. Maybe I'll do a kit share, like just show you all my kits, all my things that are ready to go. And then you might understand why I have a major start. I just want to start everything. Okay, Jenny Bean's Halloween Sampler by Shakespeare's Peddler. I got this on Etsy, okay? This looks like a ripoff. It looks like a photocopy, like the picture is kind of grainy. Pixely. You can't really see. And it doesn't have the Shakespeare's Peddler, you know, the banner with the people. Don't know if it's real or not. I paid for it. I hope I didn't pay a pirate. Yeah. Anyway, I love this. There's a problem. It calls for all limited edition sampler threads, which I know I won't be able to get a hold of. Yeah, but there is a DMC conversion, so that's fine. It's so cute. It says, when I am dead and in my grave and all my bones are rotten, if this you see, pray think of me or I will be forgotten. So, Jenny Bean's Halloween sampler. I got it on Etsy. So-and-so had a sale. And they had 30 or 35% off all fabric. And they have good fabric. I got a fat half of 32 count burgundy merino. I also got a yard, 39 by 55 inches, of 40 count white verdal. Verdal is even weave. So this is 40 count even weave. So I got, I hope you can see that. And it's amazing. And I have something I want to start on that. And this is crazy. This is 39 by 70 inches, so it's bigger than a yard, because the width of the fabric is 70 inches, not just 55. And it is 55 count Kingston linen. Yep. Just a yard of 55 count. I have grand plans for this, but God knows if I'll ever do it. I already have a pack water of 55 count. It only comes in white, on so-and-so at least. So I need to dye it to do most of the things I want to do, but wow. I do have a whip on 55 count, or 56 count, or 50 count or something. It's a sampler from Elizabeth Creasy from the Assembler. I haven't worked on that in a long time. That's my plan for next year, is to get a lot done on that. So that came from so-and-so, and all that fabric was actually very reasonably priced, and I'm very happy. I did some eBaying. This is Gingham Christmas by Just Nan, and I think it's very cute. And the main reason I wanted to get this is because it came with the gingham, and it's gorgeous. Love it. And the embellishment pack. So yeah, this will be something I do this Christmas. I can already see it. I bought a flower fairies kit. This is the poppy fairy. I've been looking for this one for a really long time. So I've already done the Snowdrop Fairy. I have the Willow Fairy. I think I have Almond Blossom Fairy. And I was also bidding on the Tansy Fairy because she's gorgeous. She's a small one. This one's a large one. She's a small one, a 5x7 one. But she's yellow and she's sitting in the tree and she's actually doing her sewing. And she's got a little strawberry pincushion next to her. It's really sweet. But that went for nearly $40. I mean, it is a kit, so maybe I should have been. I regret it now. yeah, but I'm very happy to have this. I love her. She's beautiful. I love puppies and I love her. So yes, happy about that. My mum gave me some presents. She gave me all these bags. They're just plastic bags, cellophane bags. This is so I can sort my fabric. I'm just going to put each piece into a bag and put in a label with what size it is and where it came from and what colour it is and how big it is. Because I'm sick of them all being loose and disorganized. And she also bought me a lovely book. Colouring with Thread, Stitching a Whimsical World with Hand Embroidery by Tula Pink. You might be familiar with Tula Pink from her quilting fabric that she designs. God, she has some beautiful stuff. I'm not super into quilting fabric, but I know that she's releasing a best of line this year, and I'm going to buy a yard of every fabric, and I'm going to make fabric bags and grime guards and everything, because her stuff is gorgeous. I really regret that I never bought... I saw Full Moon Forest at a show when I was there, and I was like, oh, maybe I should buy... you know, just a charm pack and I'll make something with it one day, and I never did, and I regret it. Yeah, so this is adorable, right? Look at this little squirrel guy. You can embroider that, or what else do we have? There's a squid in here that I love. Octopus, not a squid. There's an owl. And these are just designs that are on her fabric, and they're just... give you ideas for how to do them in cross stitch. I want to find this. Oh, there he is. Octo. How cute is he? I mean, not amazing embroidery, not complex, delicate embroidery, but I love it. So many pretty things in here, guys. The deer. Oh, I love it. I kind of, freehand embroidery is like scary to me at the moment. I do have some freehand embroidery on the go, but yeah, I'm just not in the mood to be doing it. Elephant. So yeah, I don't know when I'll do anything from this book, but I do like looking at it. So pretty. Anyway. And the other piece of haul I got was my Inspirations magazine. This is I've done that so many times. This is issue 97. I think I'll make a separate video to give you guys a flick through. I know I haven't done a flick through of issue 96 yet either, so... I'll just give you a quick view of the project page. Here you go. So you can see what's in here. Oh, that looks nice. A cruel purse. Some white work. Oh, is that black work? Ooh, a black work bunny. Ooh, I better show you that. Page 18. Oh, so pretty. I want to do this. Look at that. Look at that. Oh my gosh. I want to do that. Oh my gosh. I want to do that. That's gorgeous. Oh my god. I wonder if it's all dead. Oh, there's metallic. I want to do that. Oh, mwah. I love that magazine. Okay, that's everything, guys. I'm done. Tim's going to come home soon. So I should wrap it up. Okay. Thanks for watching. See my puppy? I hope that's my puppy. I don't know. That's an Australian Shepherd cross poodle. And this is the little girl that I like the best. There's another one that's grey. They call it Merle colour, blue Merle. She has blue eyes, like ice blue eyes. She's gorgeous. But she's way more expensive than this one. And this one just has a really bright and active and happy face, and the other one looks a bit dopey. And I know that blue-eyed dogs sometimes have vision problems, so don't know. We're just inquiring at this point, but we've inquired about a few dogs in the last few weeks, and We've been unlucky with all of them so far. So, yeah, I want a puppy. She's so pretty. She's so pretty. Oh, you can't even see her very well. She's so pretty, guys. Anyway, you'll see a puppy in the coming weeks, I'm pretty sure. That's it. I'm going to stop talking. Enjoy the rest of the Flosstube videos. Bye!